Assalamu alaikum students, how is you all? I hope that you all are doing great. Welcome to your channel, my D1D2 Scientific Academy. Today our lecture is related to Cambridge Assessment to National Education O-Level Mathematics paper. It's paper 2 and it's May 2019. Okay students, now I'm going to explain you question number 1. Question number 1 is, in 2017, Lauren had a monthly income of $1,800. Okay, part A is how much was her total income in 2017. See students, in 2017 Lauren had a monthly income of 1800. It's monthly income 1800. So if you want to find out the total income 2017, what you will do is you will just, this is monthly income now, so you will multiply and there are 12 months in a year. So if you want to find out the income in 2017, as you know that there are 12 months in a month, so what you will do is you will multiply 12 with this 1800, because each month income is 1800. So to find out the monthly income 2017, you will multiply with number of months in that year, and number of months are 12. So when you will multiply 12 with 1800, you will get the answer. So this is how I'm going to do it. So 1800 multiply by 12, so you will get 21,600. So you will multiply with, so you write on total income, so you will multiply 12 with $1,800. So what you will get, 21,600. So here you will write down 21,600. Okay, so I hope that it's clear to you. Now let's move forward to part B. Part B is, from her monthly income of $1,800, Lauren paid the following: rent $500, bills $250, food $120, travel $40, clothes $70. So part one is, each month Lauren saved the rest of her income. So first you have to find out that how much income she saved. Okay, Jean. What percentage of the $1,800 did she save? You have to find out that what percentage of $1,800 did she save. So for that, what you need to do is that how much are the total expenses. So for that, you have to add all these numbers. So here when you will add them, what you will get, 500. Okay, G. 500 plus 250 plus 120 plus 240. Plus 70. So what you will get? You will get $1,180. So $1,180. When you will add all these expenses. Now you have to find out that how much she saved. So for that, what you will do is you will subtract this money from the total amount. Okay, so total amount. Okay, so first you will write down saved amount. So for that, you will subtract the spending from the total income. Total income is $1,800 and spending is $1,180. So when you will subtract $1,180 from $1,800, what you will get? Okay, you will get $620. Okay, so as you have to find out the percentage, now it's the question is, what percentage of the $1,800 did she save? Now we have to find out the percentage. So students, to find out the percentage, the formula is given number divided by total number multiplied by 100. So given number is given to you because you have to find out the percentage of saved amount now. So for that, saved amount is $620. So this is the given number. And you know that what's the total income? Total income is given to you, that is $1,800. So given number divided by total number multiplied by 100%. Okay, you can cut these two zeros with these two zeros. So when you will multiply, so when you will divide 620 with 18, what you will get? 620 with 18. So 620 divided by 18 will be equal to 34.4. So you will get 34.4%. So this is your answer. This is the percentage of the saved amount. All right, now let's come to second part of B part. So second part of B part is, Lauren's monthly rent was increased by 3.6%. Calculate the new monthly rent. All right. So Lawrence monthly rent was increased. It's increased, so it means that you will add 3.6 in 100. So what you will get, 100 plus 3.6 will be 103.6%. Okay, ji. Calculate the new monthly rent. Like, you know that how much he pays as rent? $500. Here you can see it's $500. So what you will do is 103.6%. This percent mean out of 100. So it means that 103.6 out of 100 multiply by how much she pays as a rent? $500. So you'll multiply it with 500. Okay, you can cut these two zeros with these two zeros. Now you can multiply 103.6 with 5 to get the answer. So new monthly rent would be, if the rent is increased by 3.6%, so new rent would be, okay, what you need to do is you have to multiply 103.6 with 5. So 103.6 multiply by 5. So you will get 518. So your answer would be $518. So this is your answer. Okay, yeah, I hope that part B is clear to you. Now let's move forward to part C. Achha ji. Students, part C is, in 2017, Lauren's monthly income of $1,800 was 25% less than her monthly income in 2016. Calculate her monthly income in 2016. So students, first try to understand the question. The question is, in 2017, her income is $1,800. In 2017, her income is $1,800, which was 25% less than her monthly income in 2016. Okay, so this monthly income is 25% decrease than her monthly income, which was in 2016. So now you have to calculate her monthly income in 2016. Students, we do not know that what's the income, what was the income in 2016. So we can assume that the income in 2016 is X. So let's monthly income in 2016 is X. Now, Lauren's monthly income of 1800 was 25% less than her monthly. 25% less than mean that you have to. Students, first you will convert 25% to decimal number, so you will get 0.25. 25% mean 25 by 100, and when you will convert into decimal number, you will get 0.25. And when you will subtract it from 1.00, you will get 0.75. Okay, it is reduced now, so that's why we have subtracted, because it's written 25% less than her monthly income 2016. So that's why we have subtracted from 1.00. So we get 0.75. So it means that then in 2017, the income was 0.75x. X is the income in 2016. Actually, so in 2017, total income is also given, which is 1800. So you will divide with 0.75, you will divide $1,800 with 0.75 to get the income in 2016, to get the value of X, which is the income in 2016. So you got $2,400. So this is your answer. I hope that not clear to you.